हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर कविता काटे. वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी अ न्यू एमसीक्यूज ऑफ फिजिक्स एंड जनरल साइंस सब्जेक्ट. बिफोर दैट, इफ़ यू आर न्यू ऑन माय चैनल, प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल, लाइक द वीडियो एंड शेयर द वीडियो. आई हैव क्रिएटेड अ टेलीग्राम ग्रुप. In the description box of this video, I have given the link of this Telegram group. Just join this Telegram group for educational queries and updates. So let us start. Question number 1. Identify false statement. Here 4 statements are given. Option A. In India, the frequency of AC alternating current is 50 Hz. B. Electric generator convert mechanical energy into electrical energy. C. Electromagnetic induction discovered by Coulomb. And D. Magnetic poles exist in pairs. So the correct answer of this question is option C. Electromagnetic induction discovered by Coulomb. This is a false statement. Electromagnetic induction discovered by Faraday and independently by Henry. Second question. Find odd one out. Voltmeter, ammeter, galvanometer and barometer. Options are voltmeter, ammeter, galvanometer and barometer. So the correct answer of this question number 2 is a barometer. Barometer is the odd in this. Question number 3. The negatively charged particle considered as a free particle moving in a metallic conductor. See the options: proton, electron, neutron and positron. So the correct answer of this question number 3 is option B. Electron is the negatively charged particle. Question number 4. The quantity expressed in ohm. See the options: electric current, electric resistance, electric potential, electric energy. So the correct answer of this question is very easy. Option B, electric resistance is measured in, expressed in ohm. Electric current is expressed in ampere, electric potential expressed in volt, electric energy expressed in work and energy. Question number 5. An electric bulb is connected to source of 250 volt. The current passing through it is a 0.27 ampere. What is the power of bulb? So for this example, we have to know the formula of power. Then power is equal to what? See here, P is equal to V into I. This is the formula. We have to just put the values in these formulas. See, the volt is how much? P is equal to, just keep in mind, this P is equal to V into I. Now what happened? V is 250 volt and this current is 0.27 ampere. We have to just multiply it, 250 into 0.27. what will be the answer? Yes, the correct answer is option B, 67.5 watt. See the next question. Question number 6. If a current passing through a bulb is 0.2 ampere and the power of bulb is 40 watt, find the voltage applied across bulb. Here we have to find out the voltage. Then what formula we have to use? See, V is equal to P upon I. This formula we have to use for this example. Keep in mind, V is equal to P upon I. Now, what is P? P is power of bulb, 40 watt. Upon what is I? 0.2 ampere current. Then what will be the answer? 40 upon 0.2. Yes, the correct answer is option A, 200 volt. See the next question, question number 7. Dash dash is used to study the anomalous behavior of water. Voltmeter, galvanometer, Hope's apparatus, barometer. So the correct answer of this question is option C, Hope's apparatus is used to study the anomalous behavior of water. Question number 8. Identify the false statement. The four statements are given. Option A, at dew point relative humidity is 100%. B, relative humidity has no unit. C, latent heat of fusion is Q is equal to ML. D, if a temperature of water is raised from 0 degree Celsius to 10 degree Celsius, its volume goes on increasing. Now what will be the false statement? Yes, the option D is the false statement. What happened in this? If a temperature of water is raised from 0 degree to 4 degree centigrade, 0 degree to 4 degree, and then goes on increasing in range of 4 degree to 10 degree. So option D is the false statement for this question number 8. This is the anomalous behavior of water. Question number 9. Specific heat of water is dash dash calorie per gram degree Celsius. Yes, option A is correct. 1. Question number 10. The vapor content in the air is measured using physical quantity is called absolute humidity, dew point, relative humidity, humidity. So the answer of the question number 10 is option A, absolute humidity. Question number 11. Water expands on reducing its temperature below dash dash degree Celsius. 0, 4, 6, 15. Yes, the correct option is option B, 4 degree Celsius. Question number 12. Burn from steam are worse than those from boiling water at same temperature. Because, four options are there. A given quantity of steam contain more heat than same quantity of boiling water at same temperature. Given quantity of steam contain less heat than same quantity of boiling water at same temperature. Given quantity of steam contain equal heat of boiling water at same temperature. None of the above. So what will be the answer for this question? Yes, a given quantity of steam contain more heat than same quantity of boiling water at same temperature. That's why burn from steam are worse. Question number 13. Here we have to solve the example. Calculate the amount of heat required to convert 15 gram of water at 100 degree Celsius into steam. In this example, what will be the specific latent heat of vaporization? Specific latent heat of vaporization of water is constant is equal to 540 calorie per gram. So what will be the formula? See the formula. Q is equal to M into L. This is the formula. So we have to just put the values in this formula. What is M? M is the mass, 15 gram, and L is 540 calorie per gram, specific latent heat of vaporization of water. So 15 gram into 540 calorie per gram. What will be the answer? 15 into 540. What will be the answer? Correct. Option A is the correct answer. 8100 joule. Question number 14. When an electric current is passed through a solenoid, it shows magnetic line of force similar to a bar magnet, डिस्क मैग्नेट, स्फेरिकल मैग्नेट, हॉर्सशू मैग्नेट. द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज बार मैग्नेट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 15. एट द टाइम ऑफ शॉर्ट सर्किट द करंट इन द सर्किट रिमेन्स सेम, इंक्रीजेस, डिक्रीजेस, इंक्रीज इन स्टेप बाय स्टेप. सो द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन बी, इंक्रीजेस. सो दिस क्वेश्चन 16 रिलेटेड टू फिजिक्स पेडागॉजी. व्हाट इज द लिमिटेशन ऑफ प्रोजेक्ट मेथड स्टूडेंट गेट इन द हैबिट ऑफ सेल्फ स्टडी. स्टूडेंट डेवलप ड्यू टू डेमोक्रेसी. नॉट ऑल एलिमेंट्स कैन बी टॉट इन दिस वे. डेवलप स्टूडेंट्स क्रिएटिविटी एंड रीजनिंग पावर. सो द करेक्ट ऑप्शन इज ऑप्शन सी. हियर ए इज रिटन ऑप्शन सी. नॉट ऑल एलिमेंट्स कैन बी टॉट इन दिस वे. दिस इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. दिस इज द लिमिटेशन ऑफ दिस प्रोजेक्ट मेथड. क्वेश्चन नंबर 17. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग फीचर्स डज अप्लाई टू एक्सपेरिमेंट डायरेक्शन मेथड्स. एक्सपेरिमेंट डायरेक्शन मेथड, देर इज अनदर वर्ड फॉर दिस लेक्चर कम डेमॉन्स्ट्रेशन मेथड. सी द ऑप्शन. दिस फॉर्मूलाज आर यूज फ्रॉम कॉन्क्रीट टू एब्स्ट्रैक्ट. द लेसन इज इजिली अंडरस्टूड बाय लुकिंग एट द एक्शन. द रोल ऑफ स्टूडेंट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. द पावर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन एंड द पावर ऑफ कंजेक्टिव डेवलप्स. सो द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन सी. द रोल ऑफ स्टूडेंट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस स्टेटमेंट इज नॉट अप्लाइड फॉर दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट डायरेक्शन मेथड और लेक्चर कम डेमॉन्स्ट्रेशन मेथड. इन दिस मेथड द रोल ऑफ टीचर इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट दैन द स्टूडेंट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 18. इन विच मेथड द मेन टास्क ऑफ द टीचर इज टू टेक द स्टूडेंट फॉरवर्ड. एक्सपेरिमेंटल डायरेक्टिंग मीन्स लेक्चर कम डेमॉन्स्ट्रेशन, प्रोजेक्ट, लेबोरेटरी एंड लेक्चर. सो द करेक्ट ऑप्शन फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 18 इज अ प्रोजेक्ट मेथड. प्रोजेक्ट मेथड इज द वन ऑफ द मेथड विच इज अ स्टूडेंट सेंटर्ड मेथड. सो सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन 20. In 5-way model in physics, during the phase of the students applies various measures of actual application of new knowledge. 5-way means elaborate, evaluation, engage, explain. So what will be the answer of this question number 20? Yes, option A is correct, elaborate. We have to elaborate the concept. Question number 21. DLP is, this is the tool. Digital light processing is, which type of tool? Unprojected, projected, audible, audio visual. So the answer of this question number 21 is option B is the correct, projected aids. Question number 22. What professional activities should a physics teacher focus on? Workshop, memory awareness class, discussion session, all of the above. So the correct answer of this question is the option D, all of the above. Question number 23. Dash methods are not used much for curriculum design. There are different methods of curriculum design. See the option linear, historical, component and concentric. So the correct answer of this question number 23 is historical methods are not used for the curriculum, is not used much more for curriculum design. Mostly concentric method and linear methods are used, and mixed methods are also used for the curriculum design. See question number 24. When teaching physics, the combination of which two subjects is useful for explaining the structure of electric current or diagram of electric circuits? Physics and biology, physics and painting, physics and chemistry, physics and geography. So the correct answer of this question number 24 is physics and painting. The correlation of physics and painting is very much useful while teaching the electric circuits, diagrams of electric circuits, like that. Question number 25. Identify the following untrue or false statement. Course duration is longer. The curriculum is a broad concept. There is more formality in the curriculum, in the syllabus. The syllabus is useful for curriculum development. So the answer of this question is option C. There is more formality in the syllabus. Now here two concepts are there, syllabus and curriculum. So the curriculum is informal or non-formal. So thank you, students.